Hi there, this is Umberto here. This is Inside the Hive.tv, the show that takes you into the world of bees. If you want to know more about bees, please consider subscribing and also hit the bell button so you don't miss a single video. This is the video number 2 of the video series about the PNAS paper of Dr. Sammy Ramsey. We got together to celebrate his achievement, and we made 2 videos about it, talking about the what's next in his career and possible new ways to control Varroa based on the results of he presented in his article. So if you don't know what we're talking about, I'll leave a link here in the corner so you can go back and watch the video number 1. And without further ado, let's go straight to the video. I also read that tropical labs was found previously in rats.
Yeah, that's weird.
You know what I'm saying? This is a kind of mite that's not specific. He can feed apparently in every living thing that arrives and close by. First time I was in Thailand, I was terrified.
Yeah?
When I opened a hive and I saw that creature. That's why I did my video so fast. I was so concerned that I want everybody to know as fast as possible. Do you think that tropical labs also take advantage of fat bodies?
That was a lot all at once.
I know.
I'm going to address the first part first, and then we're going to get to the fat body part.
All right.
Tropical labs is an organism that is a generalist. So it seems to be that it recently evolved from a generalist predator that was able to transition to being a parasite. And for that reason, it still seems to have the biochemical machinery necessary to translate a lot of different things into food. Varroa destructor doesn't seem to do very well if fed anything other than fat body. It also doesn't seem to do very well away from honeybees. They have to be with honeybees. It's the only circumstance where we've ever found them reproducing. They will not live long apart from them. However, tropolalaps mites seem to be able to survive in colonies of other forms of honeybees, not just Apis mellifera, the European bee. They seem to be able to survive feeding on creatures like carpenter bees, which are very different biologically from the honeybees. And in addition to that, the very first time they were described, as parasites collected from rats. And for almost a decade, we thought that they were another rat parasite until we found out that they were actually more closely associated with the honeybee colonies that the rats were trying to lodge themselves in for warmth than they were to the rats themselves. So, yeah, it's a little bit concerning when you really think about a generalist predator or a generalist parasite like that being allowed into the US and all the different hosts that it could potentially utilize and damage. But you asked, but you asked about fat body.
Yes, I did.
And the fat body question is a big one for me because tropolalaps, they produce gigantic eggs. I mean, when I say their eggs are big, it looks like it's more than 40% of the mite's body volume is just egg. And it's one single egg that they're able to produce that is just huge. It's pretty much every day that they can produce an egg of this size. Now, when you're reproducing at a rate like that, when you're producing an organism that large every day, you need a substantial source of nutrition in order to be able to do that. And the bee's blood is not going to be a good source for that. There's just not much in the way of nutrition. However, fat body tissue is just chock full of all the nutrients you need to make some pretty big babies. So I'm thinking, if given just those 2 options for what the mites could be eating, I'm thinking it's not the hemolymph, it's not the bee's blood, it's probably the fat body. But that is just speculation at this point. I have had no opportunity to actually test that by feeding these mites or doing any of the sorts of experiments that were done in this study. Is this still in the frame?
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
You're still in the frame.
I mean, I'm not going to get tired of looking at this for
a
long time.
No, that was
time.
A good thing. Enjoy. Enjoy this achievement, my friend.
Thank you.
How you kill those bastards?
Yeah. How are we going to kill these bastards? Well, I don't think that it's a good idea to attempt to use contact insecticides that or miticides on these mites that they need to be exposed to for long periods of time, because they don't spend very long on adult bees, and that's usually the time where we expose these parasites to pesticides to try to reduce their populations. So we know with Varroa, there's the period of time that they're inside of the cell, and there's a period of time that they're on the adult bees. And it's this period of time on the adult bees that we target, and then we expose them to pesticides to try to kill them. And we've got a good window of time to do that. It's about between 3 and 13 days that they're on adult bees, with an average of about 7 days. So we've got a week's worth of time to expose them to pesticides. Tropolelaps, it's only hours. They're on the adult bee population between 12 and 24 hours. That doesn't give you a lot of time to make sure that they are adequately exposed to these insecticides. And what's worse, we know that tropolelaps have a lot of genes necessary for them to develop pesticide resistance. And we want to make sure that they don't just immediately become, they don't quickly become immune to pesticides. Well, the way to make sure that a creature is going to quickly develop an immunity is to expose them to a pesticide in sublethal, in low levels, constantly. And I think that's what we would end up doing if we tried to target the population of the mites that are on the adult bees. What we need to target is the population under the cabin.
My job as a field guy, a researcher, my job is to kill Varroa. That's my mission right now. It's the worst enemy of honeybees right now. I'm always looking for opportunities like that. And I want to discuss an idea that came together with your discovery with the fat bodies, and also another discovery that just was announced a couple months ago. I don't know if you heard about the vaccine.
Yes.
You heard about
the vitellogenin vaccine.
Yes. You guys don't know what we're talking about here, I also made a video of that. Mm-hmm. Is it here in the corner. I got an idea I want to discuss with you. I want to know your opinion about that. Now that we know that Varroa feed on fat bodies, mm-hmm. and that vaccine, and if you look at the papers and the patent, you can see that honeybees have a capacity mm-hmm. to allocate things.
Yeah, between generations.
On the fat bodies. Mm-hmm. So do you think we're going to be able to one day to use this knowledge to attach something that can kill Varroa and feed the bees? The bee is gonna deliver that to the fat bodies, and then we kill those bastards. Mm. I'm working on something. I cannot share it right now.
Oh yes, I am too, sir.
We need to talk.
Well, you're now seeing the finger pyramid of sinister contemplation.
I know.
Mites should be shaking in their ambulacra. Yes. Just the little foot pads.
Yes.
They should be really worried right now, because we've got a lot of options open to us that were not open to us before. There are researchers who have tried to put some sort of chemotherapeutic, some sort of insecticide inside of the bee's blood so that when the mites fed on the bees, it would kill the mites. And it never really worked out. They never really got an effective amount of kill from this, and the reason likely being that they were putting it in the wrong place. Now, we could target the fat body tissue itself, but we really wouldn't want to put a pesticide in there because then it could biomagnify. The blood of the bees is something that's recycled on a regular basis, but the fat body that you emerge with as an adult is the fat body you're gonna have for the rest of your life. It can easily stock up large amounts of things that we don't intend to be in there. So I'm cautiously optimistic though. When we look at options like the vaccine that was discussed earlier, where there's a way to use a set of proteins that are naturally occurring already in the bees as a carrier for something that we want to get into the mite's body. Now, the site of vitellogenin production and storage is the fat body. If we could potentially get something attached to the vitellogenins that the mites don't like, something that kills the mites or sterilizes the mites, well,
yes.
Now you're seeing the
thing. Yeah, you open a lot of doors.
Oh, yeah.
You open a lot of doors.
Well, thank you, sir. Yes. It's been a collaborative effort. I got to work with a spectacular team of researchers, and I cannot thank them enough for all of the help that they provided. People The idea that we were working with was one that seemed crazy at the beginning, and so I wasn't expecting people to get on board with it the way that they did, but it just, from one researcher to the next, people connected with the idea, they got on board, they contributed their resources and their talents, and we ended up with what I think is a really exciting product from this that I think a lot of researchers will be able to build on going forward.
I'm very happy for you, my friend. I'm very happy for you, very excited about this publication. And I'm doing this video also to help you to spread the word. You know, there is a lot of good stuff here. How are we going to finish this? I don't even know. I'm going to get closer. All right.
What's up?
So I got this opportunity and I couldn't, you know, we opportunities like that, we need to make it happen right
Absolutely.
Now, especially now I'm far away.
Yeah, he's in Florida now, guys.
Yeah, this guy here in Maryland still. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please, if you like this video, please hit the like button, share with friends and family, subscribe if you didn't already.
For
not
sure.
Only my video, my channel, but Dr. Bugs here with us. And thanks for watching Inside the Hive.tv, the show about bees.
The show about bees. And if you are not yet convinced that insects are the coolest creatures on the planet, tune in next time, because I'm pretty sure we can convince you.
Yeah. Thank you. See you guys later.
Peace out.
Bye.